Okay, let's see how this goes.
How dark it's gotten. Have you a light source? The dragon's roost is just beyond. We should hurry.
Remember the button, though.
We near our journey.
So welcome. This is Dragon's Dogma, Dark Arisen.
It shows itself.
This is the auto-included DLC version. I will not be playing the Xbox or PS3 version. I actually have it. I don't think the 360 works, but I do actually have the original version of this game. I do not have the Guts DLC. So, I'm missing the best part of having the original version.
Our kind is ever ready to fight by the
I've got it, though. The DLC. No, the game. We're gonna go up this way. So you can fight everybody here. If you're new to the game, I recommend it. But I'm going to attempt to skip it. This is going to be a min-max low-level run. So we're going to do as much as possible while at the same time doing as little as possible. So for instance, we didn't fight those hobgoblins, but we saved us. So that's just a taste of what we'll be doing. Stamina will drain while you're carrying stuff. I want to take out more than just him with that, but do the same to him. Sometimes you can take all
three of them. Now, strike!
There's this mob.
To me.
Lure them down and strike!
Good combos. So we're gonna run towards the door, because I think you have to. In order to. He's trying to.
I'll fight with fire,
I guess
it most recovers.
Like she.
Let's hasten to the dragon's roof.
And then you come back. Yeah, there they go. You need these harpies to come in. They will not spawn on you. Now there is a chest back here, so we can hit it.
I'll go at once.
Alright, so she's singing, she's trying to put one of us to sleep. I'm gonna use the help to try to get a fire enchantment. If we did enough harpies, we can now move on.
Survivors, let's join them.
I have it!
We get our enchantment, we did not.
I'll draw its attention!
Oh, two. Come on.
Very well. Arisen! This way, sir!
I'll go at once.
The worm awaits beyond, sir.
Take
I should have
chanced
to that, too. You don't need to pick up any of this. If you're new to the game, you might. The combat can be a little tricky.
Arisen! This way, sir!
Our army is routed to your advance. Taken out, I'm gonna open my menu and drink a milk. That's gonna restore some health and a little bit of stamina. I'm gonna round with the goat ball. And we're gonna combo the goat twice. And then grab it. And that way we're already on it and stand up.
Fall silent!
I'll aid you at once!
I wish I had some fire.
Focus your attack!
Okay, so I'm getting thrown around. There we go. Doesn't matter what we use now, so I'm just gonna fill my stamina up.
faster you get thrown off, the smaller you are, the less stamina you have, but the harder it is
now
to throw
choose,
you off.
Flee or step forth.
There's
take
a nuance.
Hold of what lies beyond. Claim mastery over the eternal.
I'm just gonna skip the end of that. Sorry if you're new to this. This is a great game. If you've never played it, I highly recommend you stop watching and you check to see if the game's on sale. If it's not on sale, come back. Please come back. Great opening cutscene. I'll save that for if you want to see it yourself. So here we go. Does gender matter? Yes. Yes, it does. Simply put, there's a couple camps that you come across that are singular gendered, and depending on what gender you are, they will attack you on sight. Oh, I actually have to use my keyboard. I feel dumb. So I'm going to weave out for a moment. And then I think we can actually go back to controller. A bit weird of a way to do that, but... Excellent, excellent. So, we're just gonna make ourselves a sweet looking character. Let's start with bold. I'm gonna go with face shape. So, I will be cutting most of this out of the actual video. But, I do want to actually do something for now. That seems like a small face. That's a pretty small face. Perfect. I would like... large eyes. Green feels like a good color, but I'm gonna go with red. Friendly eyebrows. It's got that almost sad look. Curved or straight? I think it's curved. A small mouth, but that one looks like he's saying "je suis," and I don't want that. He looks so friendly. Perfect. One of the most important parts. Does height matter? Not really. There's only a couple spots in the game that actually require height differences, and it's just a couple item chests. There are some map parts that you have to discover by being a small person, but I've actually read that if you can cheese them by having a small pawn, which is a side character, and throwing them inside the area, and they'll open a chest and it'll actually trigger to the game that you've been inside that place. So you don't actually have to be small. The main thing that is affected by height is your weight, believe it or not. And it is your weight that determines what size of character you are, I think. Height might also affect stamina regeneration. I'm not exactly sure. It's all really nuanced. I will probably learn more as I do this playthrough. But for now, we're just going to make a sweet-looking goblin. Let's make him as small as possible. What are we looking at? What is that? 137.9? weight with the arms? I always go with 4. No matter what character I'm doing, I always go with 4. Best legs in the game. Is it goblin hunch? Goblins are hunched, right? Now, ladylike or macho, this is kind of dumb. It's unnecessarily gendered. But I actually prefer these two. Because if you notice the hands, as they get closer, they'll actually start to cut into most armor sets, no matter what size your character is. If your character is bigger, it's going to be that classic Dark Souls Havel's armor where everything's clipping into itself. So I actually prefer these two, where your hands come out further, and you're more likely to not have your hands inside your thigh armor. So we're actually just going to go with macho. Wonderful. And now we will make the character we're actually going to play through with. I think I want Slim. And where is Resident Evil Village? Bam. I'm a big fan of hairstyles I actually have, personally. So I'm feeling that one. This one. They don't have pigtails in this game, do they? I currently have. I just call them braids, but I believe the technical term is pigtails. I don't remember them actually having a pigtail. Oh, wait. That is what I have. Is that what the back of my head looks like? Oh, God, it does look like a horse's ass. Hank Hill was right. I can make Luann. Face shape. One that just changes your neck. Bam. Min-max the neck. Don't though. Oh my god. Who knows it mattered? Who knows mouth and eared? That was terrible. I'm gonna have to cut that. It's the cart titan. Visible? No. And max the ears. Got all that. Build. Skinny. This is so ridiculous. I think I'm gonna sneeze. What am I looking for? That's actual min-maxing. That's too bad, because that's the one I'd go with. Doing that. No, too big. Always go with fours. The reason is because look how close all the legs are. And then bam, thigh gap. It's the only one with a slight thigh gap, and it keeps your armor from clipping. I mean, everybody wants a thigh gap too, but like, again, you come in here, macho, bam. Suddenly your armor's not clipping. But you come in here and you go ladylike, you come back to legs, and you throw on those, and you are a mess in the pelvis region. Look at my right hand. It's already clipping. Already clipping. So again, four. Stance. Macho brings the hands out, spreads the legs. Armor looks incredible. Oh, wait, no. Scars. This one always confuses me because this is where freckles are hidden. Wrinkles, none. Because my skin is flawless. We're gonna do that one. And I'm gonna do red. We'll do that. She's definitely the lighter color. Sexy vampire lady. She's not even a vampire. No. Yes? I'm gonna be honest, I've only ever seen the distortion runs. I do not like Resident Evil, it's too scary for- that's not true. I like Resident Evil, it's just too scary for me. Too scurry. Oh, nice stretch. We're gonna get ready to actually start here. Let's take a look at our characters though. Duality. She literally weighs twice as much. She's almost twice as big. That's too bad they didn't let you make them twice as big. I'd be happy looking like either of these people. Oh, shoot. We did not change our voice. That's basic. Is this a six? No. Five's not bad. Eight? Nope. That's hilarious. Two? She's not that big. Chest. I don't think she'd have that big of a diaphragm. Sound. I think it's a 10. Yeah. Only 10, I see. Okay, let's start this. So you'll be immediately confronted with a dragon. There are three ways to take this fight on. You can die instantly, and it will just take you through the fight. You can fight the dragon. Or I think you can just run around long enough that eventually the dragon will kill you. Like, a slow death. I don't actually know. If you just run straight into the fire immediately, that's how you do it. So, like, run to the left, run to the right, jump attack, hit his arm, hit his leg. Try to just keep comboing. So we're gonna try to do as much damage as possible. Now I'm gonna run up here, try to catch this leg. He's gonna take some steps. Then I'm gonna come back to this leg. Bam. going to proceed to rip our heart out. Spoilers. Spoilers over. Here's a big moment. So if you're min-maxing, this is huge. This is where you pick your class, or vocation in this game, I should say. Each vocation has a rank, and that will determine what skills you can learn. You can combine some skills from some other classes to some, but not all of them. We'll talk about that more later, but the main thing for now is if you're min-maxing, pick fighter. If you're just having fun, pick whatever you want. Literally just pick whatever you want. Have some fun. But I'm going to pick that. I'm going to look around the room, see if there's any items. We're going to pick up a mithridate. Some oil and stuff. I feel like there's one more thing I could have gotten. I'm going to skip that. A little bit of story. There's oil. I think I just remembered what it was. I believe there's a crate. Two of them. That's right. You can actually smash those. And get items out of them. This game is really cool. There's a lot going on here. So, really, really look around. Take advantage of your surroundings. Try not to kill anybody. That's why I'm smashing everything. I could be attacking it, but... We're just collecting. If this is your first time through the game, I highly recommend playing on easy mode. If you're a veteran to this kind of game, and you're like, ooh, I'm tough. I know this stuff. I've been through the ringer. Play on easy mode. Not because the game's difficult, but because you can actually duplicate items by playing on easy mode, and then whenever you're ready, you switch to hard mode. And when you switch to hard mode, the game will restart, so any story items that you want to duplicate, you can actually get a second copy of. So we're going to do that. We're going to jump down here. Getting a little frame rate issue. I'm going to come out here to this little bush, and I'm going to gather some stuff in it. Nice little pan. That is not stick drift, that is me panning over so that you can see the harbor where we'll be headed next. I don't think there's anything else to gather. Okay. So we're gonna come up here, grab some chests. A conqueror's pearl. That's a nice item, we want that. A light cure, that's not so good. And a coin pouch. The light cure is a good item, it's obviously a curable, but we don't need that right now. Grab that. Throw it, nothing, and then we're gonna search. A cloud wine, that's craftable. And another cloud wine, very good. There are seagulls here, you can kill them. If you're min-maxing, do not kill them. You can grab fish there, but I'm not going to. I am going to jump up here, grab some more mithridate. We're gonna run out here to the boats. This boat. Throw it out there. Anything? Nothing. I'm not going to jump out on that boat. You can, but the items you get are only worth a few hundred gold. I don't really want that. I want that. Now, there is only a certain chance to get that. Normally, you only get about 1,000 gold, but that was a pretty rare drop. Very helpful. So, like that, you only get about 1,000. Alright, so we're going to line up and get a big jump. And that is the brine trying to get us. That is a life form in the water. Try not to get eaten. So we got away. We're going to grab ourselves an empty flask. And an airtight flask. There's more fish here if you want to collect it. You don't have to. We're just going to keep running. There's a lot to discover in this game. Take a moment and look around. But geez, you saw me use one of those earlier. Took far too many swings to get that. Nothing. I am looking for another flask. There we go. empty flasks are very helpful if you're new to the game. You can fill those with a healing water, and it will heal everybody in your party, sort of like a mass, or like a bigger potion, like a max heal. It's just a max heal, because that's a different thing in other games. That's confusing. We need game developers to agree on a universal lingo for healing items in games. I used to think that was a thing, because Kingdom Hearts had Cura and all that stuff, and then I'd play Final Fantasy, and I was like, nice, they get it, they get it. But then I wasn't stupid one day. That's not true, I'm still stupid too today. We're gonna come up here. There are more farmables. I probably should have run down there into town. We're actually supposed to talk to a certain lady, because she sells items we need, and she doesn't actually sell them all day, so we probably should have talked to her. But we're just gonna try to get this farming in. So I'm grabbing these green warshes. They're a helpful item. The Granzy herbs sell for more. The green warsh is a healing item. The Granzy herb is a craftable. So you can sell the Granzy, keep the green warsh. You can actually keep all of them. When we switch to hard mode later, we'll be getting money like it's nothing. I do recommend, if you're new to this game, playing on hard mode eventually. It is harder, but with the way this game works, it's pretty much exponential. By the time that the game actually gets too difficult for you to handle, you have the resources available to you. Sweet pollen is a craftable, and it's a very good one. Not exactly. Did we get it? Nice. Okay. I didn't think I was going to make that. Now, this is going to play a certain sound. That is a quest sound. That means we have a quest item in our inventory. Am I gonna grab that? I didn't grab that. Okay, that was kind of lame. So we're gonna come up here. I'm gonna climb this. I'm gonna come in here. Grab some more pickled mushrooms. Nice. Nice. That is a craftable item. It's a good one, too. It is unique to this town. We are in Casardis, so Casardisite is obviously a item unique here. Okay, that was a demon's parapet. That's not what we wanted. I don't think there's anything up here. Just a bunch of jars and stuff if you want to bust them. What we do want, I think, is... Nope. We'll take that as well. It'll be nice in my bank. I like to have usually one of every item in my bank. So I'm actually going to come down here and see if she's still selling stuff. She is.
You look well.
What I want to buy are mushrooms. I'm just going to kind of knock everything else off the list. I don't like seeing that new. But we need mushrooms.
You look well.
So... make sure you get the mushrooms. Actually, I should probably just,
You look well.
So let's see what all we have to sell. We'll sell that. You can sell these if you want to. I'm not going to, because I'm going to sell that and that. Keep this. Always keep these. You can sell these. Again, you can sell your Granzy's herb. Scriptures we can sell. Blank scroll we can sell. You can sell that if you want.
You look well.
I want... yeah.
You look tight.
All the mushrooms I can get. So if you notice, we are definitely slowed down now. But we're not done. Grabbing that. There's more stuff to get. You are rewarded quite well in this game for exploration. Do not be afraid to explore. Now, if you are standing on something and it is pushing you off actively and you can't get good footing, you're probably not meant to be there. But if it looks like you could double jump and get there, it's probably because you can. Or if it looks like you can just get a little further with your double jump, it might be because you need levitate from the mage class. They're very creative in this game, but I think that was one of their downfalls because they didn't finish the game. I think they kept adding stuff, seeing what they could do, and eventually they got too much. I wish I could quick save because this might kill me. Okay. We didn't die. I was attempting to grab the ledge. Did she leave? Alright, so she left. That was exactly what I was afraid of. So I'm glad we did talk to her. Okay. I had to remember which side was actually to heal. We're just gonna go ahead and heal up with some of this. Could have eaten an apple, but it would have taken a few apples, so might as well just use that.
Hello.
I'm actually going to buy a sword from her. You can buy sleeper arrows here. We'll need those eventually. I actually don't have enough for the sword. Interesting.
I only wish I had.
You could offer me a discount. Perfect.
I only wish. I only. You always.
I should have definitely equipped that. I don't know why I didn't. Oh, I haven't. Wow.
I only wish. You always will.
She does not sell the mushrooms. So again, you need that older lady to do it. And I think she's, yeah, she just stands there in the middle of town, which is like super annoying. Because again, those mushrooms are really helpful. You can actually set them to a hotkey button, but I've never gotten it to work. Like, annoyingly so. It's one of the reasons I wanted to get Dragon's Dogma on the computer. But like, I still couldn't get it to work. I'm gonna guess that it's a me problem, but the hotkey button wasn't always in the game, so I learned to play without it, so it's not really like I'm missing out. That's actually not true. I'm totally missing out, but it's not like mentally it stresses me out because I never learned to use it in the first place. I think there's another bush we can gather from over here. I could be wrong. I am wrong. You can accept a quest right in here from her. I'm actually going to steal her flowers. I can't. Huh. I thought you could. There's a couple more chests in town that you can get if you want to. I'm going to pass up on them for now. Instead, I'm going to come in here to the inn. I'm going to...
How should I find you?
Search this one last spot. Got some more stuff. Very nice. Here's the inn.
Michael, what can I do you for? As you will.
So I'm gonna deposit a bunch. Meats and fruits will spoil in your inventory, so be aware of that. I want to deposit 200 of these. Put all of that away.
As you will.
If you need money, you can come in here and you have stuff already. So long as you have the, Dragon's Dogma Dark Arisen version. If you just have Dragon's Dogma, this stuff won't be in there. But this sells for 300,000 gold. Or no, this one does. I think it's this one. So if you need money, just sell this stuff. Or use it. And you don't need it. But
as you will. What can I do to take care?
However, I am min-maxing. And will not be using it at the moment. We're going to come out here and we're going to encounter our first pawn. Well, actually, no, we did encounter a pawn in this tutorial. This is our first pawn. We experienced pawns with another arisen. This is Rook. My man, Rook. Who looks shockingly like Nicolas Cage.
That man you are speaking with, they not... Why don't...
Before. He talks about the Declaration of Independence a little too much. So I'm skipping a lot here. The big thing to take away from this is we're about to encounter a man being attacked by goblins.
To the encampment.
If you are just having fun, save him. He's up there. You can't see him, actually. You can kind of see him. If you are min-maxing, do not save him. We do not have the right items equipped to benefit from saving him right now. So we're going to pass. I was hoping to get a mushroom from that log covered in mushrooms, but three rocks, I guess, are okay. Night Cry is a craftable. We will use that. Cape Flowers are a craftable. We will use those. Back here, I don't think there's anything. Yep. Night Cry again. We're going to drop down here. Now that there's nothing to really worry about hidden, we'll do that. Harshbud Milk. That's the one we actually want. There's Harshbud Juice, Sauce, and Milk. Milk is the one you want. I'm gonna come in here. Get ourselves a little bit of gold. Anything? Nothing. There's fish over there. No, that's just a contact spot with the water. Very nice. So again, if you're just playing this game to have fun for the first time, definitely save that merchant up there. He's one of the best merchants in the game. Those small and large nuts, conquerors, pair up, that's what we want. Excellent. That raises your strength. So you can put as many of those on one character at a time as you want. And you can basically just like... You might not be able to put as many as you want, but you can probably put at least like 10 on somebody and just do massive amounts of ammo. So silencer arrows, not really something you want. But we're not going to be coming back anytime soon, so we'll just pick it up. If you are going back by a chest soon and you don't like the item you got, you can actually just leave the item in there and come back, and the chest will reset. So long as you don't pick up the item, you can come back. Now, that's where we're supposed to go up there. If you look at the map, I can actually open it. But I'm going to show you that no matter what you do, you can't go around that little castle. Actually gonna pick that up as a seeker's token. We have a quest to, I think, collect 20 of those. You can actually get one from the first three chests underneath the main household. Hide armor, that's a little uncommon. So we'll equip that. I'm gonna run around here. And eventually, I believe we will trigger the quest, an ebon neck wrap. Look at us. Second secret token, very nice. Empty flask, empty flask. Again, I will be using those. I thought I'd make that. It's a two-handed sword that gives you a little boost. You get like a little 1 or 2 foot boost to your jump when you jump with a two-handed sword and attack in the air. It's like totally physics defying. So I think I swear there was one more chest. I guess not. So that's as far as we can go. We can go no further. The water is too deep. So we will go back. At least I think it's too deep. I actually don't know that for certain. Yep. Oh god. Yeah.
Too deep.
Out of stamina, so I'm gonna hit help.
Hold on.
He will come back and he'll give me a little boost. If that happens to you in combat, be ready to just be knocked on your ass. Somebody is going to hit you and they are going to hit you hard. Last arrow, very nice. Those weigh a lot though.
Chests all hold articles and treasures of great value.
Sure, some stuff. And then we're gonna get our. Yep. Boom. A little bit of experience.
Oh,
master. My knowledge.
Can you hear our voice?
If memory serves, I know the way, Master. Follow me.
Alright, so I'm gonna come right here. There's some collecting to do. Very nice. Liquid Vim is essentially an item that gives you infinite stamina. Very helpful. This bag right here can give you war bugles. Very nice, that's what we wanted. I think you have to collect. Might be 20 of those. I think it's actually 50. It's a lot. We'll come across more later. You can search over here. Now you see dose of strength and dose of courage, and you're like, oh, nice. We'll use those to buff ourselves later. And you'd be wrong. Those actually restore strength. So if your strength has been lowered, you can use those. Quite a few collectibles back here. So don't be afraid to come back here and grab some. Another Hearthspud milk, very nice. Nice. A Sunbright, excellent. Kindling is used to make arrows for the most part. I think that's it. Oh, found a sweet pollen. Wow, Rook's finding stuff. You can actually steal Rook's stuff. Eventually you can get Rook off of your team, and if you just take all of his stuff before then, you obviously get it. This is the first camp. I think you can actually be arrested at for attacking people, so be careful. They're usually not too happy about that. Again, you want to weigh as little as possible. So I'm going to drop all of this right now.
What will it be today? Have you come against you?
Come in here. I'm gonna talk to this rock. Which is weird, but it's whatever. And then there's gonna be a little event that goes on. And this is gonna be our first soft reset point. We are going to fight a Cyclops.
There may be prowling monsters about.
And there's goblins around. And if we kill the goblins, we're going to want to restart. So I'm going to save and continue after getting that fire enchantment. We've got 150 experience at level 2. Again, we just want to kill the Cyclops. So what I'm going to do is sprint at him and grab. Immediately start attacking. Sure that was no goblin slain. way to actually check. I believe it's options. No, it's quest. No. History. I'd get it eventually. Enemies. Cyclops or Cyclopes. Let's go to the body of it first. We got a single rugged bone. That's bad. That is a bad drop.
Anytime.
Wow. That's about as bad as it gets. Huh. Okay. Well. At least we got it first try.
We've done as asked. Let us go and give word of it. Set out from here and we'll be on the path to Grand Soren.
So we're gonna come back here.
We can have your pick. What will it be today?
Deposit that because it weighs a lot.
What will it be? Have you come again?
I'm gonna come in here. We're gonna complete the quest by creating a pawn. So I'm going to create a female. This is. There's something flying around me. I'm here with an 8. It's gonna drive me insane. And again, like I said, if you make your person as small as possible, you will be able to throw them in that tiny little gapped area. Adjustment. Not bad. If her bun was pulled tighter, I don't like her hair coming out like that on the ends. You always pull your bun tight. It's a power bun. It's power hair for better off Ted. That's not bad. Long hair. This is literally half her body. Small version of our hair. I believe that's everything. this all kind of depends their AI or changes their AI. So I'm gonna go with quick thinking. Kill all enemies. Leave them to me. And a brave hero. So we'll just do fighter. And that way she should play a tank. And just get the ever-living shit beat out of her. And again, she's small enough that we can just go... So I'm gonna skip all that. Bunch of nonsense. Where could this gate lead? What I am gonna do is come in here.
We are a vagabond people, born in a drifting world. We
talk to this man.
Will it be?
And we are going to try to grab ourselves some pawns. So you can come in here. Find pawns.
Is everything in order, Master?
I'm going to release him.
May our paths cross.
I'm going to look for some ladies, because again, it actually does matter to some extent. There we go. Fighter male. Fighter female. Fighter female. We want mages. Bunch of fighters. There we go. That's a strider. There's a mage. Fire boon. Ingle. She doesn't have a heal spell. There we go. This is kind of your only chance to get level 3s as well, so... Okay, so she's just got it in a different order. Okay, I think I'm just gonna have to take these two. At least she's got Ingle. Okay. I was hoping for one with Fire Boon. Okay, that's not exactly what I wanted. What is with this combo? Is that just all that's available right now? Antidine Leaven. Yeah, that seems to just be the most common thing on them. I think I'm just gonna have to take her. I'd really like a fire upgrade.
Yes, Arisen. I am honored to travel. Yes, Arisen. I am honored.
Okay. That'll have to do, I think. We'll do one last one. She's got the same thing. Oh, wait. Oh, shoot. Dang it. So close. Alright, well, that'll have to work. So now we have a full team. Oh, yeah, okay, I'll take that. It's one of the best healing items in the game. Alright, so now we are going to go back to the first town.
Well sturdy, this place.
If you want to, you can actually explore almost the entire map right now. Okay, so try to ignore those goblins up there.
Share these roads with traveling peddlers, guardsmen, and other folk.
Okay. Excellent. A little cutscene's gonna play out. That's okay. You do get infinite stamina in town. Oh, she's leaving for the day. Yep. Oh, we just missed her. I was gonna buy some more mushrooms. It's okay though. We're going to come out here to the inn.
Well, Madeline.
Business, but what can I do you for?
As you will. Drop that off.
As you will.
Good. Yep. I'm going to.
What can I do you for?
Rest.
You seem tired.
Stay till nightfall. So that was basically explaining that if you play online, people can rent your pawns, and when they do so, you get Rift Crystals. Rift Crystals are a currency. Little cutscene's gonna play. Are a currency that you can use to buy certain items. We will be needing a lot of Rift Crystals, specifically for a purification process.
Take care of the water's edge.
You, I have dire need. You have, I would.
So we're going to talk to her, and she's going to take us to a DLC-only location.
Is that the fate you've chosen of your own will?
We're going to come here. There's a lot of stuff to do.
Were it possible, I would not send you off with so.
So we're going to do that. We're going to open this. It's a mahogany cape, so we're going to leave it.
Oh.
I'm going to call my people over
take
here.
The offensive!
Hopefully they don't pick it up.
Just a moment.
I'm on my way.
We're gonna come in here. Again, if you don't like the item you get, don't pick it up.
Heed these words.
Sometimes your teammates will pick up items, but just ignore them.
Do not think
they won't be a problem for much longer.
One foot in front of the other, and by the maker's love, just a moment. Keep swinging.
I'll go at once.
I am looking for rings. Rings that you wear on your fingers. So I'm gonna wait for my stamina to come back. Death is going to spawn. Be aware of that. Pick up an item here. Item there. I'm gonna try to dodge him. get us far enough away that death can't get us. I'm gonna climb up here. Grab that. A throw blast. And rift crystals. Very nice. A rift fragment. Very nice.
No normal goblin.
We'll grab a hearthbud milk.
Monsters arisen, ready yourself!
I'm gonna loot this. And I'm not gonna grab that.
I heal your wounds.
What greater curse than immortality?
We're gonna come through here. And we're gonna start farming. We're actually gonna get ambushed by another person. And they're gonna end up being a friend. Starts off as a foe, but ends up being a friend. But before that, I'm going to... Nice, you got a rift fragment. Very nice. They both did. I'm going to congratulate them with a healthy throw over the edge.
Please help me.
My consciousness fades.
The reason for that is there's a lot of chests in this area, and they're gonna open them. You do not want them to open them. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna come over here. Fall down here. Fall down there. Large coin pouch, I'll take that. And a lift stone. It's very rare that you don't get a lift stone out of that one. So if you do, just go ahead and take it. If you get annoyed by their constant complaining that they're dead, you can just leave the area and come back. Drop down. Come over here. We're gonna open this. Wakestone shard is not what we want. So next one. Detoxicating powder is not what we want. So next one. We're gonna come back here. You can actually harvest from these. There are quests. Collect a ton of skulls, so pick some up. Now, that deer is really annoying, but don't kill it yet. We'll get to farming. We just picked up our first little mining pick. You could have bought one earlier, but we didn't. You can harvest all these little mining nodes. You can actually hit them with swords and stuff too, but I only like to harvest that one in this area. We don't want that. And again, by not picking up the items, these chests will reset, so we can come back to this area and try all of these again. Not what we want. Lift stones are actually teleportation items for this area, though, so try to have at least one or two on you at all times. Getting some frame rate issues. A rift crystal, we do want that, so take it. If you're probably piecing this together slowly, you've realized... That
Please
is how we're getting
me.
All of our rift crystals. Now again, normally, you would have to go online and rent somebody else's pawn and then send their pawn back in order to give them points, but if we just simply procure them this way, we don't have to play online. Sometimes you can't play online. So, if you can't play online, don't worry. I am going to
I
be playing offline, and I'm going to show you how to do all this. Right now, I'm just collecting all of these consumables. King's Warsh is about 5 to 6 times as potent as a Green Warsh, so it's a giant upgrade. Make sure you pick all of them. We're gonna come up here. Accidentally used all my stamina. If you go into your menu and you use a consumable like a mushroom before you run out of stamina, or as you run out of stamina, you actually don't take the negative side effects. Oh, they both finally disappear. Wonderful. So that's a Wakestone shard. We're not going to take that. You need 3 Wakestone shards to make a Wakestone, and a Wakestone will revive you if you die. We want a skeleton key from this one. Oh, Bitter Black Novelty 1. Interesting, you don't normally see that. We'll actually pass on that, I think. Maybe not. That's an interesting one. We'll actually take it. So, the way Bitter Black Novelty's weapons and armors work is they're actually set as soon as you start your game. I never knew this, but you cannot open one and then switch your save and then, like, throw it away and try to open a different one. You have to open X amount of them to get Y item. So again, if you open one and then throw it away and then reset your game and then open a different one, it doesn't count. You have to open that one so the game goes, oh, one, check. And then say the item you want is this certain sword. And, like, it's the fifth item you open. Again, you have to open five. You cannot open five of the same one and save and quit between them. You have to open one, save the game, open a second one, and then manually get to the fifth one. It's a pain, but I see why they did it. So there's a bunch of spiders here. Try not to get hit. We do want those sleeper arrows, actually. You can buy them later, but no point in that if you can just get them for free. There's snakes over here. Be careful. Pretty much everything wants to poison you. Dodge that one. Oh, a two-hander. We're actually going to pass on that, though. Grab some money up here. Very nice. We're going to come in here. If you're new to this game, this is pretty much suicide right here. You do not need to come in this room whatsoever. What's down there? Oh, they're ghosts. We might actually be able to pull this off then. Okay. Maybe we won't. We'll see. So look for the big spell circles on the ground. Straight up a wake of stone. We are being chased, so be aware. Actually, we've lost them. Very nice. Let's just double check. Good. So now, again, I believe that resets everything. So worker. Yep, he got us. Stone. Not exactly what I wanted. I opened that one for sleeper arrows. I want a ring out of this one. Nope, we got throw blast again. Let's come back around. That one. We didn't take any of these, though, I think. Put the stone again. Thundering Spear Tome is actually a spell. Missionary's Robe. Wow, that should not have come back. exactly sure why this respawned. Very nice. So you're probably noticing those doors. I forgot to open this chest. You're probably starting to notice those doors around the room. You cannot open those yet. However, you can perform a glitch to get through them. And we will be doing that. Not yet, though. We could. You can do it right now, this early, but we're not doing it yet.
In all this, now, wouldn't it be?
As always, drop off what I don't need. Actually, do you need those though?
Wouldn't it be?
Where did they go? There.
Wouldn't it be then? Now, will you have a look? What'll it be?
Let's see what he's got. There are a couple things he sells that are nice to have. For instance, is it in here? Yes. The Martyr's Talisman increases experience and gold, so we want that. And then the Dream Wing Nostrum lowers your carry weight. So if you're weighing too much, you can pop one of those and you'll go down an entire tier. But we want the Martyr's Talisman.
Wouldn't it be then? Now, will you have
it? We're just gonna deposit that. We're not gonna use that yet, but when we're finally ready to level up, it'll be nice to have as many of those as possible. He does buy and sell stuff. He can also upgrade items. Alright, so we're going through this door. Grab a flask.
None of it matters now. None of it.
We're gonna open the chest.
Leave me to sleep in peace.
Nice, a bicrystal. That's worth a lot. We're gonna dodge those two. Come over here. They're gonna come alive, but we're here for this. We're gonna get a skeleton key. Now, that only drops one skeleton key. You can go in this room, and there's stuff, but there's a lot of spiders. I don't feel like getting attacked. And then there's a chest right there, but sometimes that chest is a mimic. And that will kill you every time. You will not survive.
I can bear to see no more.
So there's chests here, too, but there's a lot of stuff that's going to spawn. So I'm just going to try to get away from most of it. I'm going to hit that, though, and I'm going to eat two of these and keep running. And I'm going to open this chest, though, right next to the door. Jump. Now, this is going to be a giant pain here. Get ready. This might drive some people insane. I'm going to save and quit here.
My beloved,
and I'm going to just try to book it as fast as I can up this spiral without dying. So we're going to get to here, and I'm going to hit pause. I'm going to pop two mushrooms. Run to the right of the guy. Oh, he hit us. That's not good. Run to the right. Jump the ledge. Aim for that corner. Very nice. Over here. Jump. Catch yourself. Because again, so long as you don't land, you're not out of stamina. Now go to the right of him. We're going to get attacked by a gargoyle. And 3, 2, 1. We're still alive. We're still alive. Grab the key. Grab the item. We've got the Void Key and Bitter Black Novelty level 3. Oh, that was intense. And then we're going to lift stone for some immunity frames. And we're out. We're still on fire, though. But we're out of there. I think I can actually just... Okay, it's going to go out on its own. I was going to say, I can come down here and just drench myself in water. I'm going to open this chest. A balmy perfume is a healing item. It's not a bad one, either. I'm going to pick up that lantern. It has no fuel, though. I could have taken rooks, I guess, if I really cared about it, but I don't. But juice. Pretty much if it's not a craftable item you're familiar with, or a rift crystal, just leave it. Alright, so I'm gonna come up here, we're gonna check our chest. That's not what we wanted. We're gonna come over here. We're gonna get a bunch of this stuff. Oh, I dropped off my pickaxe.
I am the procedure room. For now, Mike, if there is... If there is... Pray.
She is the one that will be purifying our items. It's quite costly, so be prepared. It's going to be a while till we actually get to see the fruits of our labor. You want lava rock from this? There we go. Hunks of platinum are worth a lot of money, and they are also an upgrade item, but they're not as common. That alluvial bowl ore, or whatever it's called, veil ore. I'll have to see it again. It's too fast. Is probably the rarest resource you can get out of this little area, but it does not actually help with a lot of recipes. The recipes it does help with are very helpful, but we won't see those for a while. Right, let's come back over here.
In my Eden, upon here it. For now, my if there is.
Did not mean to do that again, but I did.
If there is. There is the prey.
I think there's a little bit of gold over here I can collect. Yes. Yes, there is. And there's actually quite a lot to explore in here. Like, I'm just going to give you a little glance up there. But I don't have double jump yet, so most of that's impossible for me. I'm going to jump over here, over here. If you're really scrounging for gold, you can sell those. They're not incredibly useful. You can sell most things. Alright, so now that our companions are gone, we're going to explore a little more now that we're not worried about them, you know, like killing a spider or something and just ruining up our min-max. A Rift Buy Crystal, very nice. Now, I'm actually looking for a certain item I don't feel like explaining. I'm trying to remember where it is. It's over here. Alright. So you need a certain number of those. I'm going to grab as many as I can remember, which is like 2. Kept beast steak. So if you use an airtight flask on meat or fruit, they become kept. That's not a bad stamina item, it's just not what we want. Demon's parapet, not what we want. I'm gonna try to hit this. Don't hit me, don't hit me, don't hit me. Nice, I'm gonna use that. This place is like a official dungeon, so these items right here will respawn. So grab your potion wash. to get me out of their range and get me to here. The chests will not respawn that quick, but like these ground items, they all come back. So you can get a novelty out of there. I believe it's a novelty level 1. And we're just, again, we're going to collect as many of those as we can and open them all, because some of them will reward us with items that we just absolutely want. You don't need anything, but we want them. We want them so much so that a lot of the time, people will simply mod out what they don't like about the game. So we are going to get certain rewardable chest items and whatnot to make the game easier. It'll all slowly become more apparent as we play. But for now, I'm just farming some chests. Seeing what all I can get while we're still in this first easy mode kind of playthrough. Hearthspun juices are nice because, again, they're not a craftable that we're going to use for like any important recipes, so you can just go ahead and use them up, not feel guilty about it. Now, this locked door. Bam. Void key for that. Theoretically, I think you could save the void key, maybe.
It's meaningless.
And then take it to the next playthrough and use it somewhere else. But I wouldn't recommend it. I'd recommend coming this way. That's not a secret entrance. Sometimes there's secret entrances. Don't get attacked by one of these leeches. It is lethal.
Pray, haunt me no more. I could go
this
no
we're just gonna
further.
Try to run past these guys. If you need to. Mushrooms. That's why we have them. We're gonna come through here. We're actually gonna go up top first. Hearthspun juice, sauce. We won't take that because we'll just see it here in a second again. We're going to go into this room. Those actually permanently increase your stamina for a certain amount of time, so it just gives you a larger pool to pull from. I don't want them. This is where you can get some healing spring water. So do I actually have a... flask on me? Don't. Wow. Okay. We're gonna get some more lava rock. That is an upgrade item we will absolutely use. Gold ore, that is one you can use. It's not used on many helpful weapons, but it's used on some fun ones. If you're max level and you're just having fun, you can use it. We'll take that moonbeam gem door. That is going to unlock one of those doors for us. Novelty level 1. Okay. We're gonna leave that because that's one of the only spots you can get a novelty level 2. And I would actually very much like to get one of
this
those.
This place, and how it could be. No,
what would it be?
So we might come back this way. We'll definitely get enough novelty level 1s that I'm not worried about all that. skeleton key on us. Got our first earring, so that's exciting. Actually, I might just come back in. Because I'm not sure if we'll come back this way. Auspicious scents. Incense. I did not even try to say that correctly. Nope. I'm just going for the novelty level 2. I don't think if I don't get it this time, I think we'll just call it. Because again, there'll be time. Bam! Doesn't even matter. Get out of my face. Mouth dried harspice, or whatever they're called, but pass. Nope, pass. These chests down here can be mimics, so I'm gonna save just in case we die. Because I'm a stickler. I hate dying. There's no way to tell if they're mimics in this game. It's not like Dark Souls. One that can be a mimic. So we're gonna save. This might be our first quit. Is this gonna be our first quit? Nope. And it's a golden ring. Very nice. Okay. So what I'm going to do is save. This is going to be dangerous. I'm going to do a save and get ready to run through hell. Again, make sure you have those mushrooms. Actually, shoot. How do I do this? I think there's actually a spot I need to come up here. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna get attacked by the leeches, I think. Nope, it's a mimic. I'm dead. I think it's always a mimic since I saved. So here you can see new game, load game, or hard mode. We're in a load game. When you choose hard mode eventually, it will just restart the game, but you keep everything you have. Okay, so I think there's another chest in there. Check real quick. And I think that's where all the leeches are. Yes. Okay, and we died. Not exactly sure if that one's worth it. I'm almost certain it's a good chest. I'm just not sure if we're gonna farm it. We're gonna farm it this time at least. So I can show it off. But I'm not exactly sure what's in it. I think it's a weapon. Bitter black weapons and armor are determined by what class you're playing as. Kite shield, okay, so we're not getting out of that one. If I need to, I can just heal and then grab the item. The problem is getting out. I don't think this is possible on hard mode. I think those leeches will just instantly kill you on hard mode, so that's kind of why I want to do it now on easy mode. You also can't save while you're being attacked, so you can't just grab the item and then immediately book it. Oh. actually not sure which chest it is. I hope it's not the mimic chest. We're gonna pass it up this time at least. I just wanna need to at least show off this area. So these are secret orbs, they're annoying. That's an invisible Saurian, they're annoying. That's an invisible Jumbo Saurian, they just killed me in one shot. We get a lot of Rift Crystal back here, so I feel it's quite necessary to come this way. However, it's been a while since I've done the loop, so I might be a little rusty. Try not to get hit by that. And then I believe you can come in here. And they'll stop following you? No. Okay. So not what we want. Yes, that is it. Exactly what we wanted. So I can't remember where everything is in here. I know we need to go in that sewer pipe, but yeah, there's a chest. Okay. And it's another mimic. Oh my gosh, there's two mimics in this part. Okay. Let us begin the resets. That might hit me, but I didn't know. But this Saurian's totally gonna smack me. Check the box. Very nice. We know that other box isn't worth it now. Purple long kill. I don't want that. We're gonna come out here. We're gonna jump. Jump. Giant rank fish. Not what we wanted. Giant rank fish. Not what we wanted. Gosh. Okay, well that was useless. Okay. It'll have to do. So now we are back here. Check that again. Circle it. Nope, not what we want. Speak.
My, for now, my course is unch. If there is.
Pause it.
If there is, for prey.
Only a little more that we want. And then we're gonna go to the mainland and collect a bunch of items. And again, remember, after we restart onto hard mode, we get to keep all of this, and all of the chests reset. So essentially, you can double items you like, you can duplicate story items that you're not supposed to have multiples of. Crimson, chain of bracers. Okay. some really nice rings from these chests. That's why I just keep trying.
It's a human!
Found you!
It's a human!
Nice. And there's a lot to explore in this area. Oh, they actually didn't respawn this time. Oh. I'm speed running through everything is because I'm terrified. Huh, so if the potent warshes didn't come back, my gold didn't come back. Interesting. That drops a novelty. I'd like a novelty from that. Obviously, you don't always get it. Nothing's respawned here, okay. I'm going to come over here. We're gonna jump. Is that enough stamina? Wow. Not sure how that happened. Light cure, okay. We want the void key, so we're going back this way. The void key does not respawn, but that's just, you know, it's the way we're going. I just figured that'd be helpful to say that. So we're gonna go this way. Can I save and continue? Let me just double check this real quick. Yep. History. Yep. Perfect. We're just gonna try something real quick. You can use your skeleton key here. Open these as fast as possible. Sometimes that chest has a rift bicrystal in it, which again gives you 2,000 rift crystals. I believe that's the biggest one you can find at this point, at least. So we'll happily use our skeleton key for 800 crystals. That's why I saved. I think you can get a kept giant fish from that, and you actually need those for a quest. I could be wrong, but I'm almost certain you can get a kept giant fish from there. Nice. Ow. Okay. Get wet. Oh wow, the unique dogs actually spawned by the sound of it. I think they're chasing me. Maybe not. I swear I just heard their footsteps. They're these blue wolves. And they're really scary. They've got that coyote slash jackal mentality where they don't just attack you right out, they kind of stalk you. It's not great. And they're super fast. Alright, so that was nice. That was a bonus 800 Rift Crystal for practically nothing. We'll get another shot at this. I think this chest gives coins. Yeah. It's not uncommon to get one of those coin bags from just a normal enemy, by the way, once we're in hard mode, I should say. It's quite rare to see one in this difficulty. Oh geez, that should have been just a clean roll.
What is happening? What is happening?
Okay. Get through here. specifically hit has a chance to drop one of my favorite armor pieces. But obviously, since it's already opened, we can't open it again. Alright, so that item up top is not back. What we are here for is a different item. So again, put your save on. Save successful. Don't worry about the big guy, he's chained up. We're coming this way, don't get hit by a fireball. Over here. We are far enough away that they're still attacking us, but we can save. And that's what matters. Oh, we got it first try. Bitter Black weapon number one. Excellent. So there's a bunch of stuff down here. I'm actually just gonna save after that. I'm gonna get attacked, aren't I? The stone, nice. We don't have to buy one now. Bitter Black gear, nice. Conqueror's Parap, nice. I'll take a skull. Flask of oil. Easy. Is he actually gonna try to get me from here? Yeah, there's obviously another way back here, but that's not what we want to do. So I'm actually going to use one of these to teleport out of here. And I think we're actually done. I'm gonna go do one last thing and then call it quits. But yeah, I think we're totally good here. I just wanna do one last check of these chests. And then move on. Oh, there's actually one more thing that I did forget to do. Kept sour ambrosial meat. Okay. That's a really good. That's probably one of the best stamina regeneration items in the game. You know, we'll take them since we're almost done. Don't hit me, don't hit me, don't hit me. Very nice. We got our novelty, so we can just skip by the little stairwell. Just saving some mushrooms. Oh, you gotta be on the ground. We'll just go through the door.
Seems there will. It's a blessing.
Now, what'll it be then? Now, will you have a look?
So?
What'll it be then? What'll it be then? What'll it be then?
Oh, I actually need to equip it now that I'm realizing it. Come over here, we're gonna fall down, we're gonna open those last chests. Actually, it looks like this stuff respawns too. Nope. Alright, am I all good? Looks like I'm actually all set. So there's one item I want. Oh, wait, I'm ignorant to my own stupidity. I forgot to open any of these doors. Doi. Actually, I have to go down, don't I? That's what it is. Is it down or up? There's another statue piece I'm looking for. Is it down? Down, okay. There we go. Alright, so let's do the glitches. So the first and most important glitch is the Ring of Perseverance. In order to do these glitches, you put a barrel in the corner. I like to run straight into it and then just jump diagonally. And boom, we're through. Now the Ring of Perseverance is the best ring in the game. It is imbued with mysterious power and increases the discipline earned by the wearer. So discipline points are how you buy skills and whatnot, and you only get a fraction of your experience back as discipline. So you have to wear those rings of perseverance if you want to be able to actually do stuff at a reasonably early point. If you don't, it's going to take a while to level up your vocations, so we're going to actually get two of them. And that's the whole reason why I'm saying you should always play in hard mode. Because even if you're playing for the first time, you want both Rings of Perseverance, because you want to be able to try all the skills and classes. You don't want to be locked out of them just because it took too long. You don't want to beat the game and then all of a sudden you're like, I only finished two classes. You want to see everything the game has to offer. Alright, so this is where things get a little annoying. I'm going to actually have to carry... Okay. I'm going to have to carry a barrel over to this door. Do this with anything carryable. So as soon as the barrel becomes tangible, you can't do the glitch. Nice, we're through. All right. This one thankfully has a jug out front. The larger your character is, the easier this is to do, by the way. So, one of the reasons I like to make a giant character. You can die doing this as well. I'm shocked I haven't. I'm probably about to jinx that. But, there we go. Let's just save again. Set it down, and what are we going to use? We got a deer coming in. Very good, very good. Okay. I remember this one being very difficult to get out of. There's this one and another one up on a ledge that I remember being very difficult to get out of. Okay, we're out. Very nice. That's the only one I don't think you can get into with the glitch. Well, that one and that one up there. I'll have to double check. I know the one you have to fall down. There's just no way. I've never found a way to get in it. There is a way to get into this one, though, that I discovered on my own, and happily discovered that other people have recently found out in the last few years. I think COVID really pushed a lot of people to figure out what all they can do with this door glitch. Where's the barrel I'm thinking of? Oh, it's over here, that's right. Onyx ring? Yes! Oh, do I even have a... I don't have a fairy stone. Okay, so there's a good chance I die here. Yeah, no, there's a barrel. Where's the other barrel? I'm forgetting a barrel. Or did I destroy it? Oh, don't tell me I destroyed it. Oh, no. I did, didn't I? Oh, is there another barrel? Oh no. Do I need to come back? That's not good. Okay, well, while we have a moment, could I fall? You might be able to make that jump with a barrel, but that would be insane. Shoot, I might have to restart. That's embarrassing. I might have to just respawn the barrel. That's equally embarrassing. I'm not really sure what to do. I'll have to think about this. Well, what a great time to go eat breakfast. Because I'm a fucking idiot, apparently.